Can you imagine a medical condition that can cause each of your kidneys to grow as large as a football without you even knowing? But even if you are the most diehard football fan, I wouldn't be so excited about it, as this condition can be associated with many complications. This mysterious condition is known as polycystic kidney disease. In today's video, we'll discuss everything about it, starting with a brief talk about its name, as it can create some confusion among both healthcare professionals and patients. Then we'll cover the causes, symptoms and possible complications, how to get a proper diagnosis, and what is the appropriate treatment. Let's kick off by clearing up any terminology confusion. When you hear someone mentioning polycystic kidney disease, they are using a non-specific term that can refer to one of the two very distinct congenital kidney diseases: autosomal dominant polycystic kidney disease or autosomal recessive polycystic kidney disease. I know, polycystic kidney disease was a mouthful already. We are complicating even further. But don't worry, with some very basic understanding of how genetics works, we can easily make sense of it. So almost every cell in your body has 23 pairs of chromosomes, and each chromosome has a number of genes, which determine all sorts of physical characteristics of our bodies, such as how tall we are or the color of our eyes. Out of these 23 pairs of chromosomes, 22 pairs are not related to gender, meaning they do not contain any information that would determine if you are biologically a male or a female. These are called autosomal chromosomes, and any disease associated with the genes they contain, such as both the conditions we mentioned before, are also termed autosomal. Now, remember how we just said that we have pairs of chromosomes and genes? Some characteristics need to be present in one single gene to be expressed. These are called dominant. On the other hand, some traits need to be present in both corresponding genes of a chromosome pair to be expressed. These are called recessive. It's easier with an example. The gene that causes someone to have brown eyes is dominant. So if you have this gene in one of your chromosomes, your eyes are brown, even if in that other chromosome pair you have a gene for blue eyes. For you to have blue eyes, you would have to have the blue eyes gene in both chromosomes of the pair. Although in reality, what I just described is a little bit more complicated, this example is helpful to understand the terminology we're going to be using. So now that we understand the terms autosomal, dominant, and recessive, the rest is pretty straightforward. Polycystic kidney disease literally means disease that causes multiple cysts to appear in the kidneys. In this video, we'll discuss the more common of the two conditions we mentioned before, talking about the autosomal dominant polycystic kidney disease, that from now on we'll simply call polycystic disease. This condition is caused by an abnormal gene in one of the non-gender related chromosomes. Since it's a dominant condition, only one copy of the gene is needed to result in the disease manifesting. In fact, this is one of the most prevalent hereditary conditions, affecting up to 1 in every 400 people. When a person has the abnormal gene, it causes some changes in their kidneys that result in the disease. You see, our kidneys are formed by hundreds of thousands of small functional units called nephrons. Every nephron in turn contains a number of microscopic tube-like structures called renal tubules that filter out substances from our bloodstream that are meant to be eliminated from our bodies through urine. People who have the abnormal genes we mentioned before are born with normal kidneys, however, over time develop dilations in a few of their renal tubules. These dilations grow progressively up to a point where they are visible to the human eye, and they are named cysts. Cyst number and size usually increases as the person ages, ranging from a handful of cysts up to several thousand. and from less than a millimeter up to the size of a tennis ball. Okay, but what is the problem of having some cysts in the kidneys, I hear you ask? Well, some people that have this condition go through long periods of their lives without even realizing they have it. However, most of them have signs and symptoms of the disease. The most common being a dull flank pain that varies in intensity, and palpable masses in their abdomen, since the kidneys grow in volume as cysts increase in number and size. Remember when we said in the beginning of the video that it can grow up to the size of a football? Besides that, a few complications can happen along the way. As the cysts grow, they can damage blood vessels, leading to bleeding, which causes episodes of acute pain. Also, these bleeding cysts can rupture, causing blood to accumulate in the kidney surroundings, which is also a cause of acute pain. Remember that the cysts are formed by dilations of the renal tubules that contain urine in formation? Well, when the fluid is trapped in a cyst, it becomes static. In our bodies, fluids are not meant to be static. And when that happens, it can lead to several different problems. In the specific case of urine, it can lead to infection and formation of calculi, also known as kidney stones, that complicate even further the polycystic kidney disease. But the most important issue with polycystic kidney disease is that as the cysts grow in number and size, they start compressing the other nephrons in the kidney, the ones that don't even have any abnormalities, causing them to stop working. Over time, more and more nephrons stop working properly, up to a point where the kidneys can no longer perform their function. At that point, we say that the individual has end-stage renal failure. This means that to continue to eliminate harmful substances from the body through urine, that person will need external assistance, such as hemodialysis or kidney transplantation. In fact, polycystic kidney disease is by far the most common inherited cause of end-stage renal failure, accounting for up to 10% of all cases of such condition. And since the kidneys have a key role in maintaining our blood pressure at normal levels, people affected by polycystic kidney disease also usually suffer from hypertension and all of its possible consequences. Besides these complications that are directly related to kidney disease and the presence of cysts, polycystic kidney disease is often associated with other conditions throughout the body. The most common is the presence of cysts in organs other than the kidneys. The most affected organs are the liver, the seminal vesicles in men, and the ovaries in women. But other organs can also be affected, such as the spleen, the pancreas, or the prostate. Affected individuals are also at increased risk for intracranial aneurysms, which are dilations of the arteries located within the skull. The main issue with that is that these aneurysms can rupture, causing serious, potentially life-threatening intracranial hemorrhage. Polycystic kidney disease is also associated with colonic diverticulosis and various types of cardiac valve diseases. All of this sounds scary, right? But how do I know if I have polycystic kidney disease or not? The ultimate and definite tool to diagnose polycystic kidney disease is genetic testing, which is a laboratory exam that basically consists of doctors and lab technicians having a look at your chromosomes and genes to check if you have the abnormal genes that are known to cause the disease. But in most cases, this is not necessary, as there are easier and cheaper ways to establish the diagnosis. Doctors generally use a combination of clinical history and imaging exams to determine whether a person has polycystic disease or not. Being a genetic condition, most of the affected individuals have relatives that also have the disease. And imaging exams such as ultrasound, CT, and MRI scans make it very easy to actually see cysts in a person's kidneys. So through a combination of family history and the number of cysts detected through medical imaging, doctors can usually safely determine if a person has polycystic kidney disease without the need for expensive genetic testing. Don't be too scared if you ever are submitted to an ultrasound and a cyst is detected in your kidney. Cysts in that organ are fairly common, and most of them are not related to this or any other serious condition. There are other specific criteria for what number and types of cysts are considered pathological, and it's best to trust your doctor to figure that out for you. As is the case with most of the genetically determined diseases, we still have no curative treatment for polycystic kidney disease. Currently, therapy consists mainly of managing possible complications and providing support in cases of end-stage renal failure, such as hemodialysis or kidney transplantation. There are, however, some medications such as vasopressin receptor antagonists, which may benefit certain patients by slowing cyst expansion. Early detection and appropriate management of complications are still the most important factor to help patients with polycystic kidney disease increase their life expectancy and quality. And this is all for today's video. I'll see you in the next one. This video is part of Kenhub's limited clinical series and is for educational purposes only. It does not provide medical advice, and none of the information in this video should be used as an alternative to a medical exam, specialist diagnosis, nor treatment. If you're feeling any health disorder symptoms, please contact your doctor.